Dear students, wishing you all a very Christmassy morning. We are your host for the day. I, teacher Kanchin.
And I, Deep sir, welcome you all. We are here to celebrate the birth of our Jesus Christ, a symbol of God's love, goodness and kindness.
Today, let us focus on joyfully receiving the gift of God's love and sharing it with each other with great pleasure in our hearts and smile on our faces. Let us invite Jesus into our hearts.
Prayer is communication with the God. It is a longing of the soul, a daily admission of one's deeds.
Let us invoke the blessings of Almighty through the prayer service. Let's all arise and take our position for prayers. Let's join our hands and close our eyes. Ever-loving and merciful Father, we sing praises for your abounding grace that surrounds us with every breath that we take. We seek your presence amidst us as we have gathered here in this very moment to prepare our hearts to welcome Jesus. Lord, we lift up all the frontline workers. Keep them motivated so that they may be able to continue their work with sincerity and dedication. Bless their family members, Lord. Send your guardian angels to reach out to the people who are hospitalized, people who have lost their loved ones, people who are abandoned, to be their shield and buckler. We thank you for the gift of little children that you have blessed this earth with. Grant that each one of us may be able to bear the innocence of these children, so that this earth, which was designed by you, Lord, once again regains its serenity. As you have said, when two or three are gathered in my name, my presence will be there. With that conviction and deep faith, we lift up our hands and raise our voices to seek your blessings and guidance in every walk of our life. We ask this in the name of our Lord Jesus. Amen.
Prayer of the faithful, and as one shall be, Lord, Lord, our prayer. For teaching and non-teaching staff, principal ma'am, sisters, that they may guide us in the ways of humble service. For this we pray and response, Lord, Lord, our prayer.
For families in need of healing, that they may learn to love each other more deeply, support each other when troubled, and forgive each other in Christ. Our response, Lord, hear us,
that God may give us the grace to show kindness and caring for one another as we remain challenged by COVID-19. Our response, Lord, hear us.
We pray for all the children of Divine Child Senior Secondary School that they be a shining light in our lives. Our response, Lord, hear us.
God's blessing upon all our activities for this Christmas and upon all that we do. May we find God in every beginning. Our response, Lord, hear our prayer.
With silence in our hearts, let us pray for our personal and local needs. Our response, Lord, hear our prayer.
Now, it's time to enlighten ourselves with the significance of the day. Over to you, my dear teachers, to share the importance of 25th December.
It's time to light a candle of positivity. It's time to sing. It's time to taste savories. It's time to fill up the life and with happiness and joy. It's time to celebrate Christmas. Christmas is celebrated by the people around the world on 25th of December to commemorate the birth anniversary of Jesus Christ, who's believed as Son of God. It is a celebration of love, generosity, benevolence, peace, kindness, brotherhood, and familial bonding. Do you want to know how Christmas is celebrated?
Yes.
On the eve of Christmas, people visit church and offer prayer to Lord Jesus and seek His blessings for pleasure and prosperity. People buy Christmas tree and decorate it. You want to know more about Christmas tree?
Yes.
Christmas tree ka sambandh प्रभु यीशु के जन्म से है। जब उनका जन्म हुआ तब उनके माता पिता को बधाई देने के लिए सारे देवदूत उनके पास आए। उन्होंने सदाबहार फर को उनको भेंट के स्वरूप में दे दिया। आपको पता है क्रिसमस ट्री सजाने के लिए पूरे हफ्ते से पहले, एक हफ्ते से पहले उनको सजाया जाता है। सजाते वक्त आप देख सकते हैं तारे, घंटियाँ, इनका इस्तेमाल किया जाता है और गाने भी गाए जाते हैं।
Wow! Also welcome the festivities of the occasion by caroling, as it is the best charm of this festival. Christmas is enjoyed most among children as they sleep early on the day in the hope to receive gift from someone special.
Santa Claus! तुमच्या सर्वांच्या आवडीचा Santa Claus. गोल मटोल, लाल कपडे घातलेला, लाल टोपी, मोठी वाढलेली दाढी आणि खांद्यावर भली मोठी बॅग। आणि त्या बॅग मध्ये काय असतं माहितीये का? त्या बॅग मध्ये असतं तुमच्यासाठी छान छान सुंदर सुंदर गिफ्ट। क्रिसमसच्या एक दिवस अगोदर लहान मुले खिडकीच्या किंवा दरवाज्याच्या बाहेर आपले मोजे ठेवतात आणि या मोज्यांमध्ये सॅंटाक्लॉज रात्री 12 वाजता येऊन सुंदर सुंदर गिफ्ट ठेवतो। सकाळी उठल्यावर तुम्हाला सरप्राईज नाही का? असा हा क्रिसमस खूप सुंदर प्रकारे साजरा केला जातो। या सर्वांना क्रिसमसच्या या सणाच्या खूप खूप शुभेच्छा। विश यू ऑल अ मेरी क्रिसमस।
द वर्ड बिकेम फ्लेश अँड मेड हिज ड्वेलिंग अमंग अस। वी हॅव सीन हिज ग्लोरी, द ग्लोरी ऑफ वन अँड ओनली सन, हू केम फ्रॉम द फादर full of grace and truth.
The Son of God became a man to enable men to be sons of God. Here is the musical skit by our students telling us true meaning of Christmas to make the biggest footprints in our heart.
Giggles and laughter of children. Jingle jangle of bells. Joyful chorus of carolers. The festivity and the celebrations rekindle our spirit in this entire season of winter. Yes, it's Christmas. The most wonderful time of the year. Gifts under the tree, light shimmering on every window pane, a star before the door, food, shopping and party. The list goes on. In the hustle and bustle of all these celebrations, the real joy of Christmas has been stolen.
Hi John, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas darling. Merry Christmas Betty.
Merry Christmas John.
Hey John, your house looks great with all the Christmas decorations.
I can smell something baking in your oven.
Oh, it's a cake. C for cake.
I love cakes.
No, H for holiday. Holidays are the best. Off from school and off from homework.
Let's party and enjoy.
Thank you.
that night, John went to bed dreaming about how he had spent Christmas with his friends. When John woke up, he realized that it was all over.
Oh no, I have to wait for another year. December 25th is just for one day. Only one day to be happy. Oh, I wish it was Christmas every day of the week.
Hi John, Merry Christmas.
Hey Alicia, we had a lots of fun yesterday. You missed it.
We went to church as a family to thank God for sending his only son.
You went to church? That's not so much fun.
Listen, Jesus came to this earth so that you and I could live in peace. And the best way to celebrate Christmas is by thanking him for the great sacrifice. By the way, why do you look so sad, John?
That's because Christmas is over and it will come back only next year.
Cheer up, man. If you have Jesus in your heart every day, will be as exciting as Christmas Day. Come, let's read together the story of the first Christmas. The Bible will teach us the real meaning of Christmas. In the quiet little town of Nazareth lived a beautiful young girl who was pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. Angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth with a message for Mary. The angel said to Mary,
"Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give him the throne of his father David. And he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and his kingdom will have no end."
And Joseph, being a righteous man and not wanting to disgrace her, planned to send her away secretly. But when he had considered this, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying,
"Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child who has been conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins."
They both were chosen by God to be the caretakers of Jesus. Now, in those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that a census be taken of all the inhabited earth. And everyone was on his way to register for the census, each to his own city. Joseph also went up from Galilee, from the city of Nazareth, to Judea, to the city of David, which is in Bethlehem, because he was of the house and family of David, in order to register along with Mary, who was engaged to him and was with child. It was a long, rugged and dusty road. It wasn't easy for Mary, as she was expecting the baby soon.
Joseph, are we there yet?
Just a few miles more, dear.
Finally, Joseph and Mary reached Bethlehem, but there was no room for them to rest.
Do you have any room in the inn?
No, I'm sorry. We are full. Try across the way.
Joseph leads Mary to the next inn and knocks.
"Please, do you have any room for us in your inn?"
We have too many guests already. We have no room.
Joseph leads Mary to the third inn and knocks.
Do you have any room for us in your inn? We have come a long way and my wife is with child.
All of our rooms are full. I have an empty stable out back you may use. It's not much, but it will give you some shelter.
Finally, an innkeeper graciously opened the door for the couple and gave them place in their stable. That night in the lonely stable, amidst the ox and the sheep, was born baby Jesus. Mary wrapped the baby in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger. Living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their sheep over the night, and the angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them.
Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find the baby wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger.
Come, let's go to Bethlehem and see this wonderful thing that has happened, which the Lord has shown us.
Someone to be found. Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. Search for the boy who will bring us all joy. Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. We're the shepherds and here's our plan. Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. Find baby Jesus in Bethlehem. We sat in the fields with our flocks that night. The angel came, it was such a fright. Don't be afraid, he said, good news, it's joy for all of you. Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. Down to the town, there's someone to be found. Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. Search for the boy who will bring us all joy. Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. We're the shepherds and here's our plan. Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. Find baby Jesus in Bethlehem.
Immediately the shepherds said to one another,
let us go and see, which the Lord has made us known.
Shepherds quickly head to the manger, and they came with haste, and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in a manger. And when they had seen it, they made known abroad the saying which was told them concerning this child. But Mary kept all these things, and pondered them in her heart.
Where is he that is born, King of Jews? For we have seen his star in the east, and are come to worship him.
When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy.
We three kings of Orient are bearing gifts. We traverse afar.
To the house, they saw the young child with Mary, his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts of gold and frankincense and myrrh. Each wise man presents his gift to baby Jesus.
How wonderful this is! A baby worshipped by the wise men and angels. Savior, he is the reason for this season.
You said it right. If this Savior is born in your heart, then every day becomes a new day, and every day will have a reason to celebrate.
Thank you.
Created us to be instrumented with the ability to sing and make music.
Here comes our teachers with gratitude in their hearts to sing aloud and to take us to the world of joy.
Joy to the world, the Lord.
Joy to the world, the Savior reigns. Let men give a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
All good things must come to an end, but in life, every ending is a new beginning.
So give thanks to the Lord for the wonderful moments we have shared together.
To conclude our Christmas celebration, I request Sister Kavita to share Christmas message and propose word of thanks.
A warm and graceful morning to our most valued parents, worthy teachers, and my most beloved children. Without doubt, Christmas is a time of fun and enjoyment. The promise to peace, goodwill, and a growing sense of excitement and expectation makes this time of year very special indeed. Unfortunately, this year also, like last year, most of us cannot hold celebrations with families and friends because the COVID-19 global pandemic continues to impact our lives even after 2 years. As a result, we are confronted with worry, stress, anxiety, and emotional challenges caused by the ongoing uncertainties and instabilities. Christmas is a celebration of God's manifestation in this world of darkness, suffering, and death, to bring light, healing, and life. Christmas reminds us that Christ came into the world to set us free from our spiritual, mental, and emotional bondages, and to live among us, giving us the assurance of God with us, even in the midst of ongoing pandemic. Christ came to offer us strength in the place of weaknesses, fellowship in the place of isolation, courage in the place of fear, and life in the place of death. God is always present and reachable to us as Emmanuel. So let us spread the message of hope this Christmas, because hope is more contagious than COVID.
Message of angel to shepherd in the Gospel of Luke, chapter 2, verse 10 says, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people." So let us spread the joy of gospel this Christmas, because everyone deserves to be joyful. Do not be afraid to smile. Let us continue to uphold hope and share joy. May the Emmanuel God be with you always. It is not joy that makes us grateful. It is a gratitude that makes us joyful. I extend my thanks to all of you, my dear students, for being present today. I specially thank all those students who participated willingly to make this celebration beautiful. Thank you, students. I sincerely thank all my lovely teachers, Montessori, primary and secondary, who worked tirelessly in preparing this event more meaningful. Special thanks to our supporting staff, who always ready to help by doing selfless service with a great smile. Christmas is a time of peace, joy and love, a time to be united to each other. This is what we are celebrating today. Once again, a big thank to one and all. Let Christmas bring a lot of happiness and hope for a better life for everyone. Wish you all a happy Christmas and a happy New Year. Have a wonderful day. Thank you and God bless.
Let this season of Christmas bring joy, peace and love to every heart and every home. Wishing you blessed Christmas and a happy New Year. Stay safe. Thank you.